Mississippi State's Hunter Stovall, center, celebrates as he runs to home plate for the winning run against Washington on a single by Luke Alexander in the ninth inning of an NCAA College World Series baseball game in Omaha, NEB, Saturday, June 16, 2018. Natty Harnack, Associated Press, Omaha, NEB. Mississippi State's flair for the dramatic continued in its College World Series opener. Luke Alexander's drive to right field got past Christian Jones in the bottom of the ninth inning, allowing Hunter Stovall to score from second base to give Mississippi State a 1-0 victory over Washington on Saturday night. Of the Bulldogs' 7 wins in the NCAA tournament, 3 have come in walk-off fashion and a 4th on their final at-bat. "We've been through a lot this year, and when situations like that come up, we as a whole team have confidence in whoever is at the plate and that it's going to happen," Hunter Stovall said. "Coach Gary Henderson has made us be dogs. He's made us grinders. We get in the box and have confidence we're going to get this done." Stovall and Elijah McNamee singled leading off the ninth against Andy Hardy 5-3. After Justin Foscue fouled out on a bunt try, Alexander hit a 0-2 slider deep to right. Jones was playing shallow and gave chase, but he couldn't catch up to the ball as it bounced to the wall. Alexander easily scored, prompting players to pour out of the Mississippi State dugout and celebrate on the grass behind third base. "Playing for 3 years now, you kind of experience things like that," Alexander said. "Being my junior year, you just relax. When you're younger, you tense up. Me being a junior and really seeing the game so long has helped me." Washington coach Lindsey Meggs said he had no second thoughts about playing his outfield in with the winning run on second base. "We weren't going to let anything fall in front of us," he said. "That's the percentage play and what we talked about doing before the game. The guy put a good swing on it. I don't know if we catch it wherever we are." Starters Ethan Small of the Bulldogs 38-27 and Joe Demers of Washington 35-25 traded zeros through 7 fast-paced innings. Demers threw strikes on 19 of his first 22 pitches and held the Bulldogs scoreless even though their leadoff man reached base in 4 of the first 5 innings. Demers was helped by 2 double plays and some sharp fielding by shortstop Levi Jordan, who made a couple diving stops and came up throwing to get runners at first. The Huskies had the bases loaded with 1 out in the 3rd, but Nick Hull hit into a double play. They also had runners in scoring position in the 2nd and 6th innings but couldn't break through. J.P. France took over for Small and pitched a 1-2-3/8, and Cole Gordon got 1 out in the 9th before Bulldogs interim coach Gary Henderson called on Zach Neff 4-3 to come in with a runner on first for a lefty-lefty matchup with slugger Joe Wainhouse. Neff struck out Wainhouse and got A.J. Grafanino to ground out to end the inning. Mississippi State pitchers allowed only 6 hits to a Washington club that had been batting .332 in the NCAA tournament. The Bulldogs have 7 walk-off wins for the down to the last strike in a regional elimination game. McNamee hit a walk-off homer to beat Florida State. McNamee homered again in the bottom of the 9th to beat Vanderbilt in game 1 of Super Regionals, and they scored 4 times in the top of the 11th to beat Vandy in the deciding game 3. "Nerves not issue. Washington is in the CWS for the first time, but Meggs said he didn't sense nervousness among his players. He said they did get fidgety waiting in the clubhouse as the North Carolina-Oregon State game in the afternoon lasted 4 hours, 24 minutes for the longest 9-inning game in CWS history. I told one of the coaches I feel like I'm a substitute teacher in a third-grade class," Meggs said. "Our guys were bouncing off the walls and doing everything you shouldn't be doing when you are settling down and getting ready to play. With runners in scoring position, we didn't take the at-bats we had been the last couple of weeks. We got jumpy," he said. "I guess if you're a fan you watched both, you're probably appreciative of the effort out there at 2:44, considerably less than the first game today." Henderson, on his team's quick game following the 4.5-hour opening game. Up next, Mississippi State plays North Carolina on Monday in a bracket 1 winners game. Washington plays Oregon State in an elimination game in the afternoon. North Carolina beat Oregon State 8-6. Copyright 2018 The Associated Press. All rights reserved. This material may not be published, broadcast, rewritten, or redistributed.